In this video, we will review how to obtain intraosseous access with a powered drill system. An intraosseous access, commonly called IO, is used when immediate vascular access is needed and other methods have failed. The patient is commonly in distress and hypotensive. IO infusion allows access into the bone marrow to administer fluids, medications, and blood products. Typically, an IO catheter is placed in the ends or epiphysis of a long bone, such as the tibia. The blood vessels within the bone allow infused fluids to reach the central circulation quickly. To begin, we will review the supplies that will be needed to place an IO access with a powered drill system. A typical easy IO kit includes the following: an easy IO drill, needles. There are three different needle colors which designate the length of the needle. A pink needle for pediatric patients or smaller framed patients. A blue needle. Generally, this can be used on most adult sites. And a yellow needle. This needle can be considered for the proximal humerus site and areas with excessive adipose tissue. You will also need a securement dressing, and finally, an extension set that will connect to the catheter. Prior to the placement of the IO line, perform hand hygiene and apply personal protective equipment. For this demonstration, placement in the proximal tibia will be used. Begin by feeling for the tibial tuberosity. Placement for the needle will be 2 finger breadths below this point. Prepare the skin by using an appropriate disinfectant and allowing it to dry. Prime the extension set per your organization's protocol with either saline in non-responsive patients or 2% epi with lidocaine for patients responsive to pain. Following skin prep, attach your choice of needle set to the drill. Stabilize the limb and gently insert your needle into the soft tissue. The 5 mm black line should be visible above the skin. If you cannot visualize the 5 mm mark before you enter the bone, a longer needle is needed. Not having the proper needle length could result in tissue infiltration or extravasation. Next, squeeze the trigger and apply gentle pressure, allowing the drill to do most of the work. Once you no longer feel resistance, stop the insertion and remove the drill from the needle set. Then, remove the inner needle and dispose of the needle in the sharps container. The IO site should feel firm and seated into the bone. Next, place the securement dressing, then attach the prime extension set, maintaining sterility. At this point, the inserter can aspirate to see a flash of blood if your facility protocol allows. Flush your IO line and ensure there is no leaking around the site. This may be extremely painful. Consider appropriate analgesics. Finally, be sure to secure your extension set. There are some contraindications to IO infusions. These include a fracture in the target bone, previous orthopedic surgery, attempted IO access or IO access within the previous 48 hours in the target limb, infection, trauma, and burns at or around the insertion site. Finally, if you are unable to locate landmarks on the target bone. Always remember to use your clinical judgment when determining the best site of insertion. Other sites that may be used for IO access include the proximal humerus and the distal tibia. For placement in the proximal humerus, feel for the surgical neck. The site will be about 1 centimeter above this area. For placement in the distal tibia, feel for the medial malleolus. The insertion site will be about 2 centimeters proximal to this point. When placing in the proximal tibia of an adult, feel for the tibial tuberosity. Placement for the needle will be 2 finger breadths below this point.